Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I hope you're all having a good day. In today's video I'll give you my updated guide on how to reach Predator rank in Apex Legends ranked arenas, mainly focused on solo queuing and coming from a PC player. I will do my best to explain the best way to reach your desired rank, as this guide isn't only for people who are capable to reach Pred, but also for the people who want to hit Plat for the first time, for example. Make sure to like and subscribe if you find this video helpful, this really helps me out a lot. Also, if you have any other tips or if you disagree with something, please tell me in the comment section. I will discuss with you the following subjects to help you better understand how ranked arenas works. Number 1. The MMR, placement and point system. Number 2. The meta legends and team compositions. Number 3. The gun meta, counters and alternatives. Number 4. How to play the game mode. Number 5. Tips for every map currently in rotation. And number 6, the importance of good mentality. Alright, let's start. So the MMR and point system. This is very important to understand, so you can get a better idea why you get the points that you get and the matchmaking you are in. Basically, MMR means matchmaking rating. This is a hidden system which estimates how good you are as a player. This is mostly based on your previous gained rank and on your current win rate. Your MMR is also used to matchmake. If you are a high MMR player, you will play against better players. If you solo queue and you have a high MMR, you usually get worse teammates to balance it out. For example, you are a master with 2 gold chain team, facing a 3 stack diamond. This happens because on paper it evens out. Let's say the master MMR is worth 8 points, your gold teammates are worth 4 points, and the diamond players are each worth 6 points. Your total team MMR would be 10 plus 4 plus 4 versus 6 plus 6 plus 6, which both are 18. This is a hard match for you, but equal on paper. This isn't how it exactly works, but it gives you an idea why you usually get worse teammates when solo queuing. Your MMR also directly influences the amount of points you will gain. So let's say you as a player got Diamond 2 last split, and now you want to go for Masters. What you will notice is this. You do your placements and most likely you will get put in Platinum 3 and you will gain around 100 AP per game. By the way, your placement is also mostly based on your previous gained rank, so performance there doesn't matter a whole lot. But every game you play, you will gain less points. Usually it drops with about 3 AP per game you play. The closer you get to your previous gained rank, the more points will fall off. This is because the game assumes you're a diamond level player, and it makes sure it doesn't become too easy to get to the next rank. So when you get to Diamond 2, you will be getting AP in the 20s to 12 range, depending on your win rate. This is why having a good win rate is important. It's not so much about winning, but about the amount of games you play. If you win everything, your AP will drop less, just because compared to a 50% win rate, you will have to play less than 2 times the amount of games. So the system can take away as much AP, giving you a much easier time to rank up. The point system can be quite brutal. In general, it goes like this. You do your placement, get 100 AP plus on the first matches. When you get close to your previous gained rank, it will drop off heavily. And usually when you're on the same or one tier higher than your previous gained rank, you will get 20s and eventually 12s. What can happen is that you will gain 12s, but you can't win enough games, so you're hard stuck at that time. When you play a lot of games, eventually you will gain 12, but not lose 12 for a match, you will lose more, like 16 or even at the worst 30. At this point, the system basically thinks you don't deserve to be in the rank and does its best to get you to demote. At this point, you need to reconsider if it's still worth playing that season, because next season this won't be the case anymore and you want to maintain as high as a rank as possible to give yourself an easier time next season or split. The point system also gives or takes more points in certain occasions. Mostly you will gain more points if the combined MMR of your team is lower than the enemy's team combined MMR. For losing, this means the same. If you lose to a lower MMR team, most likely you will get a minus 30. So it's very important to not underestimate your opponents, because on the off chance you lose to a low MMR player, you will get punished severely. This is basically how the MMR and point system work in general. Let's move on to the meta legends and team compositions. At this point in time, the meta legends are pretty easy. You have 2 must pick and 1 wildcard, which is a legend you can pick based on your team's playstyle or current map. The main meta concerning legends is all about mobility and creating angles or pushes, hence why these two legends are must picks. The first legend you will always want to have in your team is Pathfinder. Pathfinder is an absolute top tier legend in arenas. The grapple allows you to get to the best spot every time before any other legend. Also, it can help you finish off an opponent who is weak and hiding behind cover. Also, just to take the mats and crafting materials before any other legend can. Also, Pathfinder's ult, the zipline, can be used on many maps to effectively move you and your wall team to the center of zone to create an advantage. The second must pick is Mad Maggie. Why Mad Maggie is a must pick is because the Mozambique is the main meta and extremely hard to counter once hammers are equipped. And she gets a speed boost with that gun, making it very overpowered. Just watch my solo queue to Pret in 48 hour video and you will know what I mean. Also, her Wrecking Ball is very strong to rotate and to stun someone to create an easy free kill. There are many spots on the map where you know an enemy will rotate in the start of the round. If you use your ball on them there, it creates an easy stun and knock for your team. Also, if you don't want to stun someone, you can use it to let your team rotate faster at the start of the round for that extra advantage. The third legend for your team is the wild card. Basically, you can pick the legend based on your playstyle. For example, if you want to play very aggressive, Octane, Seer and Horizon are very good picks. And if you want to play more calculated, a Newcastle, Lifeline, Gibby or Bloodhound will suit you well. You can really experiment with those legends to see what kind of team composition suits you best, but personally I like Octane, Horizon and Seer the most as a third for the composition, as I'm a very aggressive player. And those legends really help you to focus someone or create multiple angles. Let's talk about the gun meta now. Unfortunately, the meta has been very still on PC for almost 3 seasons now, and it doesn't look like this will change before the end of Season 15. And it may be like that in Season 15 too. Basically, the meta gun for PC is the Mozambique, and for console also the Mozam and the Devotion. Why the Mozambique is meta on PC is because burst type weapons usually do well in arenas. This is because people play around cover and don't expose themselves too long. Being able to get a lot of damage in a short amount of time really helps you to get the best of your opponent. The Mozam basically is a wingman that has almost the same range, way better close range abilities, faster fire rate, higher DPS, better hip fire, very easy to use and cost less. So you maybe see why it's meta. People usually complain about Mozam usage, mostly because it's very difficult to counter, and if you want to climb in Masters, you're basically forced to use it too, whether you like it or not. On console, the Devotion is still meta, mostly because spray weapons are way more viable due to the amount of aim assist, and the DPS of the Devo is just simply absurd. Also, it has a very large mag size, allowing you to consistently one-clip someone without too much effort. In my experience, the Wingman is probably the best counter to the Mozam. It hits for 45 damage per shot, and it also allows you to jiggle peek. I tried to know Mozam on PC, and with the Wingman I definitely have the most success by far compared to SMGs, for example. Also, good alternatives are the Vault and the Havoc. The Havoc is very strong mid-range, with the big mag size, which helps you to one-clip someone. And the Vault is a reliable SMG with a big mag size and absolutely shreds on controller. I would recommend the Vault for controller and the Havoc for mouse and keyboard. Also, the Peacekeeper is very strong to counter Mozam close range, but obviously you gotta hit your shots. Miss two against a good player with the Mozam and you're usually dead. But with good cover play and aim, you definitely can win with the Peacekeeper. Other good guns based on range are, for long range, the Sentinel Charge, the 30-30 and Scout. For mid range, the R301 Flatline and Hemlock if you're on controller. And for clones range, the RE45 Hammer, Prowler, Gar, EVA 8 and Alternator as first round gun. Alright, so this is everything I want to say about the gun meta. Basically, if you want to have the least frustrating time, playing Mozam is the way to go, especially if you solo queue. Alright, now moving up to how you actually should be playing the game mode. So now you know how to get your points, what legend to play and what gun to play, we can talk about how to actually play this mode. Arenas usually plays out very predictable, especially at the start. When the round starts, everyone moves to a set location, hold the angle and try to get the damage or knock in which they can push from. An old strategy I used to do is buy a lot of batteries and try to drain the opponents out of shields. This does still work, but not always and definitely not against good teams. Something that is very noticeable to me when comparing high rank arena players to low rank arena players is this. High rank arena players always look for an angle to get a lot of damage in or are very busy trying to create an aggressive push. Lower ranked arena players usually do what everyone else does. Round starts, go zone, hold standard angle and wait it out. If you do this, you should definitely work on trying to be more aggressive and unpredictable. Like I mentioned before, the game mode nowadays has a mobility meta, so people use this to either create an instant aggressive push, a push when someone is low, to take away better position than the enemy and deny them rotating to zone, or to get the so-called off angle. So with this in mind, you can do a couple things. Take position in zone, make sure you're posted up with your team in a way you can't get shot from unexpected angles, and try to get a knock or someone low to push off. With Pathfinder, Maggie or Octane, you can instantly create a push that the enemy won't expect, and this really works well to win you the round. Or with Maggie, Puff and Octane, you can use your ult to get to zone before the enemy team, hold them out until they are forced to rotate and get free shots to win the round there. You can use Horizon or Octane to get a weird angle from above or from the side. Since angles are pretty set and people know where enemies usually are, this can help you to get a knock without them realizing you even being there and get a push of that. I would suggest, if you are a solo queue, to be the aggressive player on your team. So as a Puff, Maggie or Octane, it's probably the way to go. Especially if you are Diamond, you are expected to hard carry. So in my opinion, you want to try to create the first knock before your teammates go down. You can play support legends like Newcastle and Lifeline, but I can't recommend it in solo queue when above Platinum, as relying on your team to be the aggressor really doesn't work out most of the time. Playing aggressive has always brought me the most success in solo queue. With that being said, let's move on to some tips to help you play better in each specific arena's map currently in rotation. Starting with drop-off. Best composition here is Puff, Maggie and Octane or Seer. Mainly the goal on drop-off is to take the center of the room, which usually plays out in a close range fight which ends up right there, or the other team being pushed to spawn having a major disadvantage. So you want to have mobility. With Puff you can get there the quickest and take immediate control. If you don't have a Puff, you can instantly throw your Maggie ult to get there quickly with your team and maybe even stun someone. With Octane you can go to the far door and Termite the closed door. This allows you to get a lot of damage in because you can throw the Termite before Maggie comes in with her ball. Best weapons here are the Mozambique, Peacekeeper, Vault, Gar, Devo, Havoc and Wingman. Gibby can also work out really well here too. If you get pushed back to spawn with your team, Gibby with his bubble is basically the only way to rotate safely back into center. So keep that in mind, but I would recommend to just go very aggressive and do everything in your power to not lose the center of the room. Now, Encore, a personal favorite of mine. Really like the map because of the mid-range action and it gives me an advantage as a mouse and keyboard player. Best comp here is Pathfinder, Maggie and Octane or Horizon. This map either pushes left or right basically. In my opinion, what you want to do here is have two teammates going to center zone and have your turret playing the off angle. On this map you really don't want to be sitting on the same place together because this allows the enemy team to easily out angle you from multiple spots. So two in zone and one mobility legend on the off angle works out very well in my experience. Also, Octane's pet and Puff Scrapper work out really well if the zone pulls to the section on high ground, as taking position of zone before the enemy team's there usually results in an easy win that round, as they are denied to even get into zone and are stuck on low ground. On this map, the best guns in my opinion are the Mozambique, the Wingman, Havoc, Vault, Devotion and R301. Moving up to Overflow, also a very nice map to play off angles. The best legends for this map are Pathfinder, Maggie, Octane and Horizon. Also on this map, if the zone pulls to the open section, I like to have two people try to get to the center and one on the off angle close to them. For the off angle, Horizon and Octane are very good. If the zone pulls to house, buying a jump pad and a peacekeeper really allows you to get control over the zone or get an easy knock because the house is always played aggressive and should be tried to get control over. Also you can Maggie ult someone who moves to the house and get an easy knock like that. Puff can grapple either to the center or to the supply bin to get free shots like that, or just to take the house too. Best weapons here are the Mozambique, Vault, PK, Eva 8, Devo and Car, as close range weapons obviously perform best here. Next up is Phase Runner. This map is focused on all types of range and a lot of weapons are viable here. The best weapons in my opinion are the Mozambique, Vault, Havoc, Wingman and R301. but this map definitely allows for freedom concerning weapon choices. The best legends for the map are Pathfinder, Maggie, Horizon and Bangalore. When playing the portal sites, people like to use their Maggie ult on the bridge. This allows you to hard push the enemy and skip the whole poking part, which happens a lot there. Also, you can play a lot of angles there, for example by the mountain or near the boxes to the supply bin to create a knock that way. I would suggest you either hard push or take weird angle, skip the poking part since that will lead to you 50-50ing the enemies. Also, sky nading are very effective, especially when people fall out of the port at the start of the round or when they try to cross the bridge. On the other side of Phase Runner, I feel like it's kind of an awkward place to fight, but in general I like to have one person holding the supply bin from either the two buses in the center or the crafting metals and two people on the other side. When all three enemies rotate to the two teammates, you can rotate to the supply bin and shoot them in the back. Best guns here are Mozambique, Wingman, Havoc Vault, Devotion, R301 and Sentinel. Quick tip, Bangalore's ult is super strong on the portal side to push them off their height and create an easy push. Now the last map, Party Crusher. Best characters here are Pathfinder, Mad Maggie, Octane, Seer and Horizon. Party Crusher is for me the Sky Knight practice map. This really is the map where Sky Knights are very strong and not that hard to land. If Zone pulls the ship, I play Octane or Horizon and play the off angle. You have, in my opinion, a good and a bad side. If I get the bad side, I play at the supply bin or at a piece of cover close to that. If I have a pot, I will instantly push them by padding on them with the Peacekeeper. When I get the good side, I will do my best to hold position because at that point it's an advantage. If Zone pulls the other way, a puff zip line or Octane jump pad to get to center first will really help you get an advantage over the enemy. If you can hold them out, this will should result in an easy win. Also, Seer ult is really nice to have here. It's a chaotic place to fight and that really helps to negate that. Horizon is very strong here to play in center or engage pushes on ship side. Or just to create angles from other places. Really, there are countless of good angles you can take with Horizon on both sides. Best guns here are the Mozambique, Wingman, R301, Havoc Vault, Flatline and PK if Zone pulls to the building side. Now, that were some quick tips and information on how to play the maps. Now let's move on to something really important, which is your mentality towards the game. It's no secret that Ranked Arenas is very tilting from time to time, especially when you're solo queuing. The matchmaking and maybe toxic randoms really can make you very, very mad. Also, when you're playing with a 3-stack or just with one person, it's very important and very favorable to maintain a positive attitude, as your tilt will degrade the skill of your teammates too. I will see a lot of people will just throw away their points because of tilt, and I'm not immune to that either. If you get mad, at least take a break, especially after a minus 30 loss and sudden death for example. Being tilted takes away your ability to get in the so-called zone, which is where you perform best. And if you're solo queuing, you always need to perform your best to climb. Also, if you're mad, you will play lazy and not care as much. You're mad, but eventually you will just throw your points to prove the point that this game mode sucks, for example. A good mentality and join the game mode will always bring you the most success and tilt will be your downfall. Remember that, this is very important. Something to take into mind is how the matchmaking is designed and you just can't win all of them. And that really doesn't matter. Your rank doesn't show your skill at the end of the day and it's all about improving, not bragging about being a predator. Make sure you enjoy the journey and focus on the moment. So this was my updated guide on how to reach predator rank in Arena Season 14. I really hope this has been helpful to you. If it is, please subscribe and leave a comment. Have a great rest of your day. Cheers!